Welcome to our introductory video on DeepLake, the serverless memory for foundation models, part of the GenAI 360 Foundation Model Certification. In this video, we'll learn how foundation models can be easily extended with an external memory by using DeepLake, while also discussing the recent trends in LLMs like context sizes, agent memory, and vector databases. LLMs, and more in general, foundation models, are deep learning models with billions of parameters that excel at a wide range of tasks like text and image generation. LLMs are trained on huge amounts of text with the aim of learning the conditional distribution of words in a language. Doing so allows them to generalize and generate meaningful text without directly memorizing the training data. They can perform tasks like translation, sentiment analysis, and chatbot conversations without being specifically trained for them. LLM can be used without fine-tuning for many general tasks by employing prompting techniques, where a question is presented as a text prompt with examples of similar problems and solutions. Typical LLMs like GPT-4 or Claude are trained on a general training dataset containing data across various domains. However, these general LLMs may achieve suboptimal results when used for domain-specific tasks. To get a better performance on more specific tasks, it's possible to train LLMs on domain-specific datasets, thus achieving a trade-off between general capabilities and domain-specific capabilities. Once the LLM is trained, its knowledge is restricted to its training set and its prompt. So suppose the model was trained on data up to 2021 and is asked about the company founded in 2023. In that case, it will lack knowledge and may even generate a plausible but entirely fabricated description, a phenomenon known as hallucination. Managing hallucinations is tricky, especially in applications where accuracy and reliability are paramount, such as customer service chatbots, knowledge-based assistants, or AI tutors. One way of giving knowledge to LLMs is via prompts. However, LLMs are limited by their context size, that is, the maximum number of tokens the model can process, which is determined by the specific implementation of the LLM. For example, if you are using the GPT-3 model, the maximum number of tokens supported by the model is 2049. Since prompts are a handful way of passing external knowledge to models, over time, models with longer context windows were developed. There are many use cases where small context length is okay, but there are also many where longer context window will be valuable. And there has been a lot of progress in increasing context length with recent models. For example, if we need to use an LLM to generate creative IDs of tweets that could be posted on an account to talk about self-improvement, we could craft a single prompt asking for tweet IDs, and in this case, a small prompt will suffice. There is no need for external knowledge here, unless we would want to generate tweets about a recent topic that the LLM doesn't know about. On the other hand, if we were a content creator and we wrote a blog post about a specific self-improvement topic, we'd have to copy-paste that blog into our prompt to have the LLM write coherent tweets about it. In this case, we need a longer context window, but still something rarely exceeding 4 to 5,000 tokens, as most blog posts are of that length. If we created a podcast episode, long 1 hour, we'd have to include its whole transcript inside the prompt, which could be several tens of thousands of tokens, especially if it's from Huberman, exceeding the context size of many of the recent LLMs. For reference, OpenAI recently released a new GPT 3.5 model with a context size of 16,000 tokens. GPT-4 manages up to 32,000 tokens, and Claude from Anthropic manages up to 100,000 tokens. If we wanted to use an LLM to help refactoring a large GitHub repositories, we may need even more than that. LLM's large context window sizes, up to 100,000 tokens, facilitate the inclusion of multiple documents or even a whole novel in a single prompt. For reference, consider token to be a unit slightly shorter than a word. Therefore, having a context size of 100,000 tokens means being able to manage slightly less than 100,000 words in a single prompt. That is, about 70 to 80,000 words. Models like GPT-4 and Claude can handle context windows of up to 32,000 and 100,000 tokens, respectively, equating to approximately 20,000 words or 40 pages of text. However, there is a trade-off with longer context windows. the number of computations done by the model increases as the size of the context windows increase, thus leading to higher costs and slower responses. Indeed, large context windows are not always used due to their high cost. OpenAI, for GPT-4, with the 8K context windows, currently charges 3 cents per 1,000 tokens for the input prompt and 6 cents per 1,000 tokens for the output completions. The latest Claude model by Anthropic with a context size of 100,000 tokens costs approximately 1 cent per 1,000 tokens for input prompts and 3 cents per 1,000 tokens for output completions, instead of the GPT 3.5 Turbo model used by ChatGPT, using only 4,000 tokens as context, costs $0.0015 per 1,000 tokens for input and $0.002 per 1,000 tokens for output completions, being significantly cheaper. Moreover, using the standard transformer architecture, which is the specific neural network type used in many foundation models, the number of computations increases more than linearly with respect to the context size, thus becoming soon unmanageable with greater context sizes. The problem is not yet completely solved nowadays, but faster implementations of transformers are now available, thus allowing for the context sizes we see today. However, often other solutions are more appropriate to provide knowledge to LLMs. LLMs can be made more powerful via integration with a memory API layer via data framework such as Llama Index or agent frameworks such as LangChain. By memory, we mean a way of letting LLMs access an external, updated, trustable, eventually private knowledge base, different from the internal knowledge that an LLM has stored inside its weights during its training. Providing an external knowledge base is a great way of letting LLMs know about recent events and knowledge without the need of new costly training. Moreover, this way of working with LLMs also enables a way of attributing sources to the outputs produced, thus enhancing reliability. Memory can also be used to store recent interactions with the LLMs, thus allowing for coherent conversations longer than the context window size, if managed correctly. Llama Index is a data framework that provides data ingestion, data indexing, and a query engine for retrieval and synthesis of enterprise data for LLMs. Its main goal is to easily allow LLMs to be augmented using private data, integrating with as many data sources as possible. LangChain, instead, is an agent framework. LangChain is designed to assist developers in building end-to-end applications using language models. LangChain offers a standard interface for memory, a variety of memory implementations, and examples of chains and agents that employ memory. Memory types include the conversation buffer memory, which allows for a simple way of storing past messages sequentially. The conversation summary memory, which allows to summarize all the previous messages in the conversation, thus being able to manage way more messages, but with less accuracy. The vector store retriever memory, which allows to store all the past memories in a vector store that can then be retrieved by similarity to the current context. The previously mentioned memory APIs typically work on an underlying technology called vector database, which are databases able to store embeddings alongside items, thus allowing for similarity search. In LangChain, retrievers play a crucial role in fetching relevant data from vector databases. A retriever fetches relevant information from a trustable knowledge base, acting like a search engine, and the LLM is then typically prompted to rearrange the information without inventing additional details. Instead, within LangChain, an index is a powerful data structure that meticulously organizes and stores documents to enable efficient searching. The primary index types are centered on vector databases, with embeddings-based indexes being the most prevalent. In this course, we'll often employ DeepLake as vector database. DeepLake provides several advantages over the typical vector database, such as multimodality. DeepLake can store items of diverse modalities, like text, images, audio, and video, along with their vector representations. It's also serverless. The serverless nature of DeepLake allows for the creation and management of cloud datasets without the need for a dedicated database instance. DeepLake works locally, in memory, in your cloud of choice, or with ActiveLoop's managed service. This streamlines the setup process and accelerates project development. It's open source. DeepLake makes creation of streamlined data loader from the loaded dataset easy, which is particularly useful for fine-tuning machine learning models using frameworks like PyTorch and TensorFlow. Data can be queried, version controlled, and visualized easily from the web. There are two terms to consider. The vector databases that primarily handle the storage and retrieval of embedding vectors, whereas data lakes expand their scope with multimodality beyond just embeddings. Additionally, data lakes are generally used for analytical use cases to process vast volumes of diverse data. A vector database is the right option if the company's current needs involve creating a knowledge base and querying data. However, if the organization intends to train or fine-tune models using their data and require seamless data streaming, a data lake becomes essential. It helps with efficient model refinement and accommodating diverse data types. DeepLake brings the best of both worlds and acts as a data lake for deep learning. Let's take the example of building a chatbot for a specialized role with such an insurance agent. In this case, we will need to handle data with various modalities, including images and text, to efficiently process and respond to user queries. To determine the claim value, it's necessary to process the image and the damaged car. Additionally, providing the chatbot with access to guidelines will enable it to respond accurately to any subsequent inquiries. Thanks to its nature, DeepLake is well suited for being the serverless memory that LLM chains and agents need for several tasks, like storing relevant documents for question answering or storing images to control some guided image generation tasks. At the same time, it's also well suited for acting as a data loader of that data for training and fine-tuning deep learning models. DeepLake's comprehensive functionality empowers users to seamlessly query, visualize, and stream data, enhancing data exploration and utilization. By addressing several common challenges faced in generative AI applications, DeepLake provides effective solutions to enhance the ML lifecycle. It facilitates the creation of a data flywheel for continuous model improvement, empowering organizations to iterate and refine their models more effectively and bridging the gap between AI production and training. It can significantly simplify the AI data stack and steps for pre-processing, training, and inference. To learn more about the intricacies and the AI data stack and how it can revolutionize your AI applications, we invite you to visit the website or explore their resources for further insights and knowledge. Stay connected, continue learning, and embrace AI data management's possibilities. Thank you for joining us on this informative journey through the different methods for providing knowledge and memory to LLMs. We hope you gain valuable insights into the importance and role of each layer, including the significance of longer contexts for foundational models, memory API, and vector databases. We cover using all of these to build many applications in detail in our course.